Galatians 3:21, is the law then against the promises of God? Certainly not! Exclamation point. For if there had been a law given which would have given life, truly righteousness would have been by the law. But the scripture has confined all under sin, that the promise by faith in Jesus Christ might be given to those who believe. But before faith came, we were kept under guard. But before faith came, we were kept under guard by the law, kept for the faith which would afterward be revealed. Therefore the law was our tutor to bring us to Christ, that we might be justified by faith. But after faith has come, we are no longer under a tutor. For you are all sons through faith in Christ Jesus. For as many of you as were baptized into Christ have put on Christ. There is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither slave nor free, there is neither male nor female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. And if you are Christ's, then you are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. I'm often, I guess this week for whatever reason is going to be about the... Good morning, Baba. It's going to be quite a bit about the connection between the Old and New Testament, and that's a funny thing. I don't know why. I guess because it is something I've often tried to fully reconcile and figure out. And then it's funny, I was talking about it the other day, and my general assumption is that it was like, I guess it all reveals the character of God, you know? How he moved in the Old Testament, how he moves in the New Testament, how he moves in our lives today. And all those are different, is the interesting thing. All of them definitely have a different timbre. And I, again, often have felt like that was meant to parallel our progression as a developing species, you know? That you need giant signs and wonders, in a land where people are nomadic people and separated by great distances, and there's not a terrible amount of communication between the nations spread around the world, you know? So really, the bigger, the better, and you've got a... And your conquering power would then be, like, literally the greatest... would be the greatest blessing you could give in a society that was permanently at war, you know? And always trying to take, you know, one large group is always trying to take from a slightly smaller group or the perceived to be weaker group, and in like an all warlord society. And then it's also funny to think that even as society's arrangements have progressed, that we in our hearts have changed very little. It's so funny that the Ten Commandments written so long ago, handed down so long ago, still really hold quite true. It's like none of those things, other than I suppose the specificness of coveting your neighbor's donkey, but all of those things are the essential human problems that run us into so many troubles, of placing other gods before us, of envy. How many dark roads has envy led you down? Sweet. Oh. Sweet heavens to Betsy. So that we might have knowledge of that which pleases God. Which I also think is crucial for our walk too. You know what I mean? To not only just know that, like, falling upon him, surrendering him, serving him, you know, clothing the naked, feeding the hungry, offering... just ourselves as a daily sacrifice, you know, and pursuing in love and prayer and worship, but then that we might know all the other behaviors, that it's not like the law has passed away, but it's merely been fulfilled in this new covenant of mercy, which is such a joyful one, because it makes it, in a way, well, not even that much easier. It seems to be easier, because then all you need to do it is easier, because you're given a helpmeet, I guess. And that God is like, it's like, I'm going to move amongst you, and draw you to live to my standard as a rehearsal for the hereafter. Anyway, those are the rambles of my mind this morning. God bless everybody, and if you want to talk, let me know.